something similar tonight. A couple minutes away from starting.
Good evening, soccer fans. We want to welcome you to Anderson Field at Bobcat Stadium. On behalf of the Grandview Heights Athletic Department, we'd like to welcome you to tonight's match between the Whitehall Rams, the Lady Rams, and the Lady Bobcats from Grandview Heights. Grandview and Whitehall High Schools are members of the Ohio High School and abide by high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. The athletes in this game are friendly rivals. We remind you that this is a game between young athletes, and good sportsmanship is expected by the participants and spectators. Please cheer for your team, not against anyone. Can't have a match without the referee. Tonight, in the middle, will be Garen Green. He will be assisted on the side with Avi Lampel and Charles Feist. Now, we got the refs. Now we need opponents. We need people to play the match. Let's start with the Whitehall Rams. I don't have this in alphabetical order or numerical, so we'll start with number 19, Brooke Greer. Number 21, Diane Martinez. Okay, let's go with the starters. We'll go with number 22, Dulcie Alvera. Dulcie. Number 28, Autumn Colson. Number 14, Abril Garcia. Number 5, Fonty Jallo. Number 27, Demi Juarez Vasquez. Number 3, Jennifer Martinez Paredes. I hope I got that right, Jennifer. Number 18, Teresa Munoz. 26, Brenda Pinata. 17, Cynthia Rivas. Number 2, Ryan Smith. Number 6, Diana Vasquez. And I know we've got our goalkeeper, Dahlia Matut. The Rams are coached by Tim Darling. He's assisted by Ron Ravalladello. Now, the ladies in blue, put your hands together. Goalkeeper Vivian Hsu. Number, she's zero on the scorecard. Number 1, Catherine Page. Number 5, Madeline Thomasiano. Number 15, Ellie Smith. 17, Natalie Smith. 18, Sophie Andrews. 23, Simone Cordes, Tortoise. Now your starters for tonight's match will be number 2, Maya Birchfield. Number 3, Abby Baxter. Number 6, Taylor Pierce. Number 9, Carly Orr. Number 10, Zoe Miller. Number 11, Lindsay Burkani. 12 is Maggie Hurley. Number 14, Tia Thomas. Number 19, Lucia Mastriani. Number 25, Sasha Pomeran. And 27, Layla Slaughter. She's our goalkeeper for the evening. Head coach, Brianna Domina. She's assisted by Terry Eisel, Andy Hayden, and Amy Cooper. Ladies and gentlemen, as we begin the evening, please stand. Help us honor America and all those that have fought to defend our many freedoms by singing the Star-Spangled Banner.
Looks like Whitehall only has 11 players, so hopefully they're
Lady
fit.
Whitehall Rams in the Grandview Lady Bobcats.
It's not quite Wrigley Field, but you get the experience. And here we go. Shot goes wide. It's Taylor Pierce after a quick start from the Bobcats. Not offsides. And it looked like Maya was offsides on that. Good stick. Nice run out of the back by Whitehall. It'll be their throw. Good ball into space. Tia gets dumped. We're going to play on. The shot just goes wide. Certainly looked like it could have been a foul, but playing on wasn't a bad option either. That's going to end badly eventually. Taylor Pierce one-on-one in the corner. And it goes just wide. That was Zoe Miller on the shot. Trickled just wide. Looked like it might have been tipped, but we're going to start with a goal kick. If we can get a ball. There we go. Nice passing. Oop. And she got it. Good passing from the Bobcats. Another shot wide. Out for a Grandview throw. Taylor Pierce. And good hands. And it's in. Taylor puts it through her. So Taylor. So Grandview on the board. Just over 7 minutes in. I think Maya Birchfield's going to pick up an assist on that.
That Grandview goal, number six, Taylor Pierce.
Oh, going backwards. Let's see if this we can work it out. Sometimes going 60 yards is too easy, so let's go 120. Little heavy, good idea. Lots of space there. Oh boy. And you're out too far now. So that'll be a free kick for Grandview. Yeah. Direct kick just outside the box near the end line. Got Zoe Miller. A little bit of space in the middle. You can get a good serve to her. That'll be out for a corner. Looks like Tia Thomas on the corner. Whoa. Fell to Zoe Miller, but goalie with another foot save. Oh, boy. Like a foul. Quick restart. Stick and keep her up with a loose ball. Keeper's been decent so far and busy. Grandview not real sharp on their finishing, but got some time to work on that still tonight. Lots of space this way. Good ball in, and the flag is up. Just over 10 minutes gone by, 1-0 Grandview. Birchfield to Pomerantz. Not quite there. Carly Orr dancing through everybody. Nice ball through. And a good finish from Zoe Miller. Nicely done. So Grandview goes up 2-0 now. Still 28 minutes to go in the first half.
Grandview goal, number 14, Tia Thomas.
So he lays it off for Tia. And into the side net again. Foul on Grandview. Not sure what that's all about, but and some subs coming in for the Bobcats.
Lady Bobcats send in. Number 5, Madeline Palmasciano. Number 17, Natalie Smith. And number 18, Sophie Andrews.
Ball. And another good save. And cleared out for a Grandview throw. Ball into space. Tia Thomas, outside left. Natalie Smith misses over the top. In some non-soccer news, I just got a text from my daughter that the new snail in our fish tank is still alive. There was some concern about that earlier, but fortunately, Gary the snail has pulled through. So, snail lovers everywhere can rejoice. Can't quite get to it. And we're going to call foul. fall on Whitehall, so it'll be a free kick for Grandview in a semi-dangerous spot. Looks like Tia Thomas coming over to take it. Wouldn't be surprised to see this on goal. And now we're going to get 10. Natalie Smith with the keeper comes up again. Nice ball. It's Sophie Andrew can't quite bring it down. It's going to run out. Zoe Miller picks off the goal kick. Another save. Rebound still there. And Tia Thomas over the top. A couple more subs coming in for Grandview.
The Lady Bobcats, they send in. Number 15, Ellie Smith, and number 23, Simone Cordes.
Ball into space. And a nice finish. Ellie Smith from Herlihy. Yeah. Nice composed finish on that. Just pass it into the corner.
Bobcats number six, Taylor Pierce back in the ballgame. Grand U goal, number 15, Ellie Smith.
So it's 3-0 Grandview now. Still over 20 minutes to play in the first half. Nice play. Sophie Andrew keeps it in. Taylor with the ball. It's going to be trouble. Taylor Pierce did some good work there. Nice move. Nice low shot. And it's 4-0. Natalie Smith. The famous Smith sisters tearing it up.
Grandview go. Number 17, Natalie Smith. Off that goal for the Lady Bobcats, number 2, Maya Birchfield, and number 19, Lucille Mastriani. Enter for the Lady Bobcats.
Nice ball, not offsides. And safely out for a corner.
Back in for the Lady Bobcats, number 14, Tia Thomas.
Looks like Natalie Smith will take this corner. First one from the near side today. And Carly Orr comes sneaking up. Nice to have a defender like Carly that can get into the offense. Just slides right up. Nobody notices she's there. The ninja.
Bobcats, number 10, Zoe Miller, and number 25, Sasha Pomerantz.
Defense knocks it out for a throw, and then with good sportsmanship goes and gets the ball. Nice ball through, a little bit of space here for Whitehall. Sasha Pomerantz says no. Natalie Smith. Nice ball in from Maya. Nice low ball. That should be a goal kick. Down to 15 minutes to go. 4-0 Grandview. Lucia puts it over the top and a little wide. I'll give Whitehall credit. They're trying to work the ball out of the back on these goal kicks. It's a tall order, but they're trying to do the right thing. Nice rip.
Is that Taylor?
I think it was. Taylor Pierce with her second of the night. That'll be an assistant. Some nice individual effort there. And it's 5-0.
And grab you goal, number 6, Taylor Pierce.
The ball cut off. Another nice low shot. Ellie Smith. Yep.
Who's that?
It's Ellie again. Ellie Smith. So floodgates appear to be opening here. 6-0, 13 to play.
And go, number 15, Ellie Smith.
See how her sister feels about that now that she's got two. See if Natalie tries to get one back for bragging rights. Just out. Lindsay Bertani right in front, and she's not going to miss that.
That was Lindsay.
Yeah. Lindsay Bertani with her first of the night.
Number 11, Lindsay Bertani on that grand goal.
And it's 7. This is one of those games where time is slowing down now. Still got 12 minutes to go, first half. Can't quite keep it in. Thank you. Nice step.
Bobcats send in number 12, Maggie Hurley.
Nice ball. Just across the face of the goal. Out for a throw. Just the way it was when I used to shoot. Under 10 now. 7-0. Nice possession there from Grandview. Nice patient play. And we're offside. Tia Thomas. Save, rebound. It's just not going in right there. Nice scrambling by the Whitehall defense. Keeps it out. And another corner for Grandview. Plays Bertani short. Pinged across and it falls.
I didn't see who got that.
I believe that was Maggie.
Hurley?
Yeah, I think it was Hurley that got that. Kind of bounced off a Whitehall defender and slotted it past the keeper.
I have number 12, Maggie Hurley, on that goal.
Nice. Oh, that did not miss by much. Zoe Miller.
Lady Bobcats send in number 6, Taylor Pierce. Number 17, Natalie Smith, all for the Lady Bobcats.
Ooh. Nice layoff. Herlihy again. Ooh. Off a defender. And into the goal. I think that I thought that went wide, but yeah. Yes. And it will be a goal. That'll be Herlihy's second.
Goal number 12, Maggie Herlihy.
Just under 6 minutes left. 9-0. Handball on Grandview. Whitehall with a little bit of an offensive push here. Layla Slaughter. There she is again, getting her name on the scorebook. Nice ball out. Zoe Miller. Oh, just wide. Off the punt. Layla would have gotten an assist on that. That's unfortunate. Lots of space. Again, we got no ball kids because of the stupid COVID thing going on. So when a shot goes wide, it takes a little longer to get the ball back. Thank you.
Less than 2 minutes left in the half. Less than 2 minutes.
And wide again from Zoe. And that's going to run all the way back to the fence. Smith, nice move. We should get her second. Yeah, that's how you finish. Very nice. Yeah, it's Natalie. So that's 10. Just under a minute to go. Good news is that we'll have a running clock in the second half. Some bad news is it'll still be 40 minutes. Grant will be trying to get one more for the break. There's a foul. Still got to call it. Looks like Lindsay Bertani wants this one. Clock.
10, 9.
We're going to stop the clock here because Whitehall was not setting the wall. So, Super Candy is going to have a strike here. Nope.
Six,
oh,
five,
I was there.
Four, three,
and that'll get us to halftime.
One.
10-0 at half. Good effort by the Whitehall goalie. She deserves a break. Worked really hard. The whole team did. No subs. It's a hot night. She was under siege. The entire night. Well, working hard. Granby's going to gather down there and talk about stuff. Famous alumni Kira Thomas walking by, part of the 2015 Final Four team. She knows she's on camera, so she will not look. Harry Eisel taking the night off tonight after some discussions with officials at Buckeye Valley on Saturday. Certain games, you know, when you're going on the road, you're just going to get a raw deal. And Buckeye Valley always seems to be one of those places. Circleville. Yeah. We're going to have a new keeper for Grandview in the second half. Mm-hmm.
Whitehall student section over here. They arrived about halfway through and have been vocal, supporting their side. Mostly masked up. That's good. Very nice. A few fans on the outside looking in today. Limited attendance inside the stadium. All right, we got 7 minutes left till the second half starts.
All right, getting ready for second half action. Coach Bree giving some final instructions here to the team.
Let's get ready for the second half of this match. The Lady Bobcats say we've got a new goalkeeper. Catherine Page is in goal for the Lady Bobcats. The next time the boys' soccer team is here, that will be September 19th. It's a Saturday, 3 o'clock start, where they take on Bloom Carroll.
All right, looks like we're about ready to go. Tia Thomas. Yeah, it took just about a minute.
Tia Thomas, number 14 on that Grandview Lady Bobcat goal.
Is that a head ball?
A hand?
No, it was a head ball.
Yeah.
It's like a Sasquatch sighting. It'll be a free kick for Grandview, about 5 yards outside the box. Looks like Sasha Pomerantz might take it. Nobody else really wants to step up to this one. She's definitely got the shot to score from here.
There you go.
That's 25.
Yeah. That's 12-0. We're not quite 4 minutes in.
Number 25, Sasha Pomerantz on that Lady Bobcat goal.
Nice ball. And out for a corner. And it's out for another corner. Palmisano on the corner. Pinging it around. Rebound, and it's in. Natalie Smith once again retaking the lead on the Battle of the Smith Sisters. That's 13.
Number 17, Natalie Smith for the Lady Bobcats.
Grandview getting dangerously close to the all-time most goals in a game. I think that's 16. So if my math's correct, we need three more. Not sure I want to see that happen tonight, but out for a Whitehall throw. Nicely played by Grandview. Lots of space now. Good defense. Oh, nice ball. That was Sophie Andrew on the cross.
And for the Lady Bobcats, number 15, Ellie Smith.
Switch. Foul on Grandview. Ball. And Sophie Andrew, I believe. No. Ellie Smith. 3-3 in the battle of Smith sisters.
Number 15, Ellie Smith. Lady Bobcat goal.
I think that gets us to 14. About 28 minutes left in this one. Catherine Page out to collect the through ball. Early distribution. Abby Baxter. Gotta show the defense some love tonight. They're having a relaxing evening so far. And they're offsides. A lot of space through the middle. And you're not going to get that today. And a foul, very late flag by the AR. It'll be a Whitehall free kick. Ball got sent away, waiting for it to come back out. And now we have two balls on the field, neither of them ready to go. And we're getting there. Into the middle. There we go. And we're ready to go. Good ball. Oh, Page with a save. And a foul. I think she made the save and then was run into by a Whitehall forward. Courageous play on that. After not having much to do in the first 15 minutes, coming out and getting a hand of a headed shot. A nice run through by the Whitehall attacker. Looks like she's going to plow through. Oh, maybe not. So Layla Slaughter scrambles to get her stuff back on. She'll be coming back in. I'm going to do a quick little water break. It's hot. Take a minute while Catherine comes off. I thought I saw Layla was putting her stuff back on. That is her.
Ready, Bobcats are going to send in Layla Slaughter in goal. Catherine is coming out. Hopefully she's okay.
See the Bobcat benched, all socially distant. Trying to keep everybody healthy through the season. Alright, I think we're about done with our water break. We're down to about 22 minutes. Clock's running. I think everybody's okay with that at this point. Bobcats holding on to a 14-0 lead. I'll try to see this one out. Like most of the fans on the outside have left. The roof across the street is empty. Got a few fans coming in, looking in through the fence. And I think we're about ready to go. Let's get back down to business here. No more messing around. Whitehall with all 11 players in their own half of the field. A low pressure approach here. That's going to run out. Nope. Yes, it will. And we're offsides. Not quite enough. Sophie Andrew with a shot on goal. Trying to get her in the scorebook. Hoping to see that tonight. Ellie Smith picks it off. Here's Sophie. And it's wide. Just under 17 to go. Chippy, Grandview throw. It's like a handball. Don't think Taylor agrees with it, but players rarely do. That'll run through. And it's in. Whitehall on the board. One right here on the 30. It looks like a two. Hard work. Been dangerous on their free kicks. Some would say that's what happens when you don't head the ball, but they do. 14-1.
And he ran on the board.
Grandview throw deep in the end. And Zoe Miller puts it wide. And one for Grandview. Might have been Zoe Miller, but I'm not sure. Checking scores on the out-of-town scoreboard tonight. Jonathan Alder continues to play one of the worst schedules in the history of high school soccer. 7-0 win over Benjamin Logan. Well on their way to a 16-0 season and a second-round departure in the tournament. Bexley 2-0 over CSG. Both of those teams off to good starts this year. Central Crossing beat West Jefferson 4-2. Not sure what that means. Just wide. And then undoubtedly the game of the night, Marion Harding beat Galleon by the score of 9-7. Now, why aren't we watching that game instead? Don't know much about those two teams, but 9-7, you know it's got to be good. Ten to go here. 15-1 at the moment. pace of the game has slowed quite a bit. And there's a lot of space in the middle right now. It's the kind of game I'd love to play in. Sophie Andrew with a shot on goal. And another one for Grandview. Number five. So that'll make it 16. I think ties the school record. Set against Heath, maybe?
Number five for that Lady Bobcat goal. Madeline Ponchano.
One other game of interest tonight. We had Worthington Christian at Rosecrans. That hasn't been posted yet, but it was a 5:30 start, so I would expect Worthington Christian to come out on top of that. Rosecrans seems to be struggling a little bit at the start of the year. But when you go out to Rosecrans, anything can happen. You could have a fight in the parking lot right behind the bench. You could have broken bottles on the field. You never know. Not that any of those things would happen. Coming out, making sure another one doesn't sneak through. Ball into space. Andrew chasing it down. Down to about 6 minutes to go. Nice run, foul, and we get the whistle. Tanny on the free kick. Mm-hmm.
out for another goal kick. That'll be a penalty. So will Andrew get to take it? She drew the foul. And it looks like that's what's going to happen. Now here's her chance to get on the board. And set a school record at the same time. Nicely done. Nice finish.
Sophie Andrew, number 18 on the goal.
So
2 minutes
17 to 1. Oh. Sloppy camera work because I just got attacked by a fly. Hopefully one last free kick of the night. Bertani on the ball. Nice run here. That's it. 17-1 the final tonight. Good effort by Whitehall. No subs.
All right,
makes it tough to play.
Whitehall.
Worked hard the whole time. Goalie
Have
played well. Got on the board.
Parents. students, grandma and grandpa, support the local athletes.
Grandview's back on the field Saturday against Bishop Reedy. 4 o'clock start here at Bobcat Stadium. And then I believe next Wednesday they're home against Worthington Kilbourn. That'll be a step up in competition for them. All right. One last check of the out of town scoreboard. Don't want to miss out on any of those Galleon updates. And
the boys.
We've got nothing. No new update. So that's it for tonight. We'll see you on Saturday.
September 19th. That's a Saturday. Bloom Carroll. Remember, this is Football Friday night.